That ABC News exclusive from Barbara Walters. All year long, we've seen dictator after dictator fall in the Middle East. And for 9 months, Syria's Bashar al-Assad has desperately been trying to avoid that fate with a brutal crackdown that has taken the lives of up to 4,000 people. All that time, President Assad has not given any television interviews to anyone in the West until now. Barbara Walters is here with us. And Barbara, I watched that interview. You were really in his face.
Well, George, there were no restrictions. There were no guidelines. We were free to ask any questions. Bashar al-Assad is a dictator by accident, a mild-mannered ophthalmologist. He studied medicine in England and found himself thrust into the role of being Syria's leader after the deaths of his dictator father and older brother. He insisted to me that he has the support of much of his country, but not many others believe that. And I began by asking him how he ended up in the position he's in. Not long ago, you were widely seen as a fresh, pragmatic leader, a doctor whose life was in healing people. Now, sir, much of the world regards you as a dictator and a tyrant. Mm-hmm. What do you say to that?
Well, it's important how the Syrian people look at you, not how you look at yourself. So I don't have to look at myself.
The protest really began after the detention and torture of children who were writing graffiti calling for your downfall. I've seen awful pictures of what happened. Why was there such a brutal crackdown?
What happened?
Well, I'll give you some examples that I saw. Yeah. A 13-year-old boy who was arrested in April. A month later, his body was returned to his family bearing scars of torture. Mm. A famous cartoonist whom you know, who was critical of you, badly beaten, his arms were broken. Mm. A singer, famous singer, who wrote a popular song calling for your ouster, he was found with his throat cut. You have seen these pictures, have you not?
No, but I
is this news to you?
No, it's not news. I met with his father, with the father of that child, and he said that he wasn't tortured.
The cartoonist. The cartoonist who was critical of you, I've seen his pictures. His hands were broken, he was beaten.
Many people criticized me. Did they kill all of them? Who killed who? Most of the people that's being killed are supporters of the government, not the vice versa.
What about the singer with his throat cut?
I don't know about him. I don't know about every
single
case.
He was a famous singer, a famous song. You don't know about it?
No, I don't think he's famous. I don't know about him.
In the beginning, these protests, the women were marching with children carrying olive branches. Nobody at that point was asking for you to step down. It has escalated. Do you think that your forces cracked down too hard?
They are not my forces. They are military forces belong to the government.
Okay, but you're
I don't own them. I'm president. Okay. I don't own the country. So they're not
my
forces.
No, but you have to give the order.
No.
Not by your command?
No. We don't have no one's command. There was no command to kill or to be brutal.
People went from houses to houses. Children were arrested. I saw those pictures.
To be frank with you, Barbara, I don't live here. How did you know all this? We have to be here to see. We don't see this. So it cannot depend on what you hear in the United States.
I saw reporters who brought back pictures.
Yeah, but how did you verify those pictures? Yeah, so it's that's why we are talking about false allegations and distortion of reality.
Last week, an independent United Nations commission issued a report. What it said was that your government committed crimes against humanity. Mm. And they went on torture, rape, and other forms of sexual violence against protesters, including against children. Mm-hmm. What do you say to them? Do you acknowledge that? Do you acknowledge what the UN said?
Very simply, I would say send us the documents and the concrete evidences that you have, and we'll see if that's true or not. You have a lot of allegations now.
Did the UN not send you these documents?
Nothing at all. They should send us the documents. As long as we don't see the documents and the evidences, we cannot say yes. That's normal. We cannot say just because the United Nations. Who said that the United Nations is a credible institution?
You do not think the United Nations is credible?
No.
You have an ambassador to the United Nations?
Yeah. It's a game you play, but that doesn't mean you believe in it.
You have said often that you don't see yourself doing this job for life. You've said you're doing it for your country. Mm. With all the turmoil in your country, is it perhaps better for Syria that you no longer remain its leader?
I don't have problem. For me, it's about public support. This is the most important thing. So when I feel that the public support declined, I won't be here. Even if they say, if they ask or not, I shouldn't be here if there's no public support.
Okay.
That's so conclusive.
What do you think is the biggest misconception that my country has of what's happening here, if indeed there is a misconception?
We don't kill our people. Nobody kill, no government in the world kill its people unless it's led by crazy person. For me as president, I became president because of the public support. It's impossible for anyone in this state to give order to kill.
Do you feel guilty?
I did my best to protect the people, so you cannot feel guilty when you do your best. You feel sorry for the life that has been lost, but you don't feel guilty when you don't kill people.